memorial mass held for 21 seminarians of St. John's Seminary in Kasese who were abducted by ADF rebels on the 16th of August 1997. Father Severinus Ndugwa, the Vicar General of Mbarara Archdiocese, condemned ADF attacks in schools over the years.
It is sad that these similar events are still happening, even not far from here at the Rubiria, that's the secondary school. We know some students were hacked to death, others were burnt in the dormitories. It is really sad. And I think also as members, individuals, and even as a government, especially I call upon the government officials that we try to go deep and look for the causes of these incidents, and probably we come to work together to reconcile with one another, bring about peace, not only in our country, even in the neighboring countries.
The annual memorial service is to pray for the souls of the departed and also thank God for the lives of those who survived the attack.
We need to remember those of our brothers who did not survive, who died. We pray for them. We believe as believers, we know we are a body and a soul. So when a body dies and rots in the soil, the soul remains. And that's why we pray for their souls to rest peacefully in heaven. And also, to thank God, those who survived, for those who survived, and they are still useful in the nation.
Father Francis Mbusa, who at the time was a student at St. John's Seminary, survived the attack. He took 3 bullets to the legs as he tried to escape.
I was one of the seminarians by that time who were attacked by the rebels and was shot. 3 bullets, this right leg, then also adjacent the ribs. 1 bullet, so I was shot, 4 bullets. The rebels came, it was around 9 p.m. in the evening. But the aim was to abduct us all. They thought we were still in the chapel praying. But after reaching the chapel, they found nobody. And we were preparing for ourselves to do mock the following morning.
Moses Baluku was abducted as a student but managed to return. He says most of the students were killed in a fire exchange between the ADF and the UPDF on several encounters.
Yes, like most of us, we survived, the 11 of us, but 10 of us died in captivity. And out of the 10, most of them died with gun exchange between the UPDF and the ADF. This was of the numerous wars that we fought with the group in search for the enemy to be totally finished, and also the enemy struggling to regain power.
In 2004, the government drafted the amnesty law that guarantees that rebels who surrender will be rehabilitated and integrated into the community. Henry Muhindo Morris, who was also among the 1997 St. John's ADF abductees, spent nearly 12 years with the rebel group. He highlights the stigma he faces in the community.
But we also call upon the communities where we live not to further stigmatize us every time being coined as rebels or wrong elements. Whenever there is a problem, we are looked at as the cause, or, you know, in case there is anything bad in the society, and then we are the first people they think about in either rounding up as possible suspects for being the orchestrators, which is bad.
Of the 21 people that were abducted, 19 were students, 2 were seminary workers, 11 managed to escape, but 10 died. Relatives shed tears in church as they lit candles in memory of their loved ones. Report by Samuel Amanyire for the news in Kasese.